Yeah, I think we all know like the situation of the format of this tournament, where actually the tournament begins in a quarterfinal stage. As much as possible, everyone here wants to avoid the top seed team, which is New Zealand. And we are in a tricky situation now. Maybe that we might end up playing against New Zealand tomorrow, because whatever we can do in tomorrow's match, we can even get a win. But if the situation don't arise, that that game becomes no bearing if France beat Korea or they draw, then we have no chance other than finishing as last in the group, and we have to play against New Zealand. So a lot of you also as we are playing at 9:30 tomorrow, maybe at 9 playing the last match, and then we can wait and see what actually like happens, and then if the situation arises that we have to play against New Zealand, we have to play against New Zealand.
Coach, after two matches, I still see that there's no real team left. Would you use the next match to get the team back together, playing as a team?
Yeah, we also try like some things that we should normally we don't do, playing Faisalmi in the midfield instead of sticking to him as a sweeper. We try playing Kevin Lim as a sweeper in his first round matches. Yeah, I also agree that it's like sometimes that we have this kind of situation of a club couple that happens in the game. Yeah, we're also aware about that. But this is the only chance that we have to try out in the group stage before we go into the knockout stage. That is one thing that I agree with you, that we are looking at that as a situation that might be better for us to just stick to the one that we used to play in.
Strategy normal,
macam Faisalmi
as a sweeper, macam normal Malaysia
balik lah.
Are you going to implement the
normal
strategy lawan Canada?
It's normal strategy is we're just talking about like Faisalmi playing as a sweeper. That's a possible. Okay, we've tried playing Kevin in a sweeper's role and tried to put Faisalmi to give us like more attack. But I think agree with what Tuchek says, that the back we have like a problem. We are not settled. Okay, so maybe if we have Razi, then we have a choice of like playing him as a sweeper and pushing Faisalmi in the midfield. But there are all these is options that we look at as we grow. We try and see what is the best lineup to go about when it comes to the crucial matches.
Are you saying
that you're disjointed because of the changes that you're making, or you're trying out? Or what sometimes we see is, are there something different, a problem that the team that you all are trying to overcome?
Yeah,
everyone says since yesterday's match, the team is not in a good spirit. Team is broken up between junior and senior. Team is have coaches from the junior team and senior players are not happy. senior players have some of the other senior players have left out, and some of the senior players are not happy. Okay, for me, it's none of this that is like playing in my mind. I just think that the team make errors. Okay, especially in the game against France, that we give a few give goals. In yesterday's match, we had 6 penalty corners. Okay, we had one ball hit the post. We had 2 flicks from Faisal, one saved by a brilliant save by the postman of Korea. Korea have like 3 short corners and they scored 2. Okay, it's not that we are not creating enough opportunity. It's not that we are not creating chances. We create chances. Okay, we just do not have the luck. At this point of time, that's how I look at it. Maybe with a little bit of luck, we would have been like in a different situation.
Coach,
Coach, do you want to say that this team now is not so harmonious?
I hear this thing yesterday after the match. I disagree with this talk. As much as I always try to emphasize on professionalism in the team, we have to move forward. We didn't drop anybody because we don't like him, or we choose not to have favoritism among junior or senior. I never do that. For me, it's purely just about hockey. If the boy is good enough to be in the team, I would definitely keep him in the team. Never done this before in my whole coaching career, and I will never do that. Because I was a player too.
And something is being done to check on this?
Yeah, for sure. When people say it's this kind of thing, we also take it seriously because it can affect the team. We'll call off to this training, and we expect the psychologist to do some activities to get the team together. Not because of all these criteria, which I don't believe, but what I think is after the two loss, definitely the players' morale is down. Okay, they need to get themselves up together.
Has it ever crossed your mind that we might finish fourth, last in the group, and play the top team of the year group?
Yeah. At this tournament, when we're going into the first match, is that it's that New Zealand will be number one team in the other group. Either you finish as number one or you finish as number three, you avoid playing New Zealand. But if you go all out for the first match and you finish as number two, you still can meet New Zealand in the semifinals. So it's a tricky situation. So it's for us to go all out in the first match or not to try out things. It's also we don't know where we'll go, is it? Or we also don't know whether New Zealand will try to sleep any games or whatever. We have to wait and see. Now we see clearly New Zealand definitely is number one, but we are in a situation that we went into Korea's game and we try to win. It's not say that we throw away the game. We try our best, but we lost the match. And Korea is also not a small team, it's a big team.
One last question. Thank you very much, Coach.